Due to the graphic content and discussion, this program may not be suitable for some viewers. Viewer's discretion is advised. The views and opinions of this show are not necessarily those of this network, its affiliates, or supporters.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything starting to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come.
Just all the stuff you guys wish you could see about me, but you never got to see.
You're so holy. More reverb and delay.
So people ask me all the time, you know, what's up with this guy? You know, you have to know that you're controversial.
Yeah.
Okay. And what I mean by that, I'm just let's give some specifics. I've seen you come to the Stellar Awards with the spiked hair, with earphones, mm-hmm. you know, huge around your neck. You've been known to wear a boa. Mm-hmm. You have been known to wear makeup. Mm-hmm. In a video, you have been known to, I've seen you with a lollipop ring on your hand.
Lollipop, yeah.
We could go on and on. Platform shoes, wigs, bobs, and nobody ever knows what vein you're going to come in. They never know if it, what is he going to wear today. Is he going to wear a bob today? You know, so that's controversial, and you have to know that. You grew up what, PAW Kojic?
PAW. Yeah.
You know, I grew up Kojic.
You know.
And Kojic, y'all was worse than us. PAW is Jesus only.
No, y'all was the one, we couldn't see past y'all's hats.
Well, excuse me, PAW, the women couldn't wear hats because they had doilies on their head.
Not our church. That's more a Church of the Lord Jesus Christ or Apostolic Assembly. We didn't wear the doilies.
Oh, you didn't do that?
Mm-mm.
But it's still no makeup.
Right.
Skirts down to your ankles, elbows
yes.
covered.
Yes.
Never a piece of cleavage ever.
No.
Never. So, yeah, you were pretty strict.
Yeah.
And for you to come up through that upbringing,
mm-hmm.
to go all the way to the opposite side
yeah.
of the universe with this.
Yeah.
Is this guy bipolar? What is he, crazy? Is he doing this on purpose? Are you doing it to make people angry? And what are you doing?
I guess it's just, I really don't know what else to be. It's really me.
Like it's really
always been me. I don't know. It's just I think it's not fair that because I'm black that I can't do the things that, you know, white cats do.
I don't think it's because you're black. I totally do not believe that. What I do believe is that when you grow up in the black church, you can't do that.
Right.
You know, we frown upon that. Right. You come on, you know how we do.
Yeah.
You can't do anything outside of, you know, wearing a suit, and you can dress down
you grow
these
up
days.
In Arrested Development, you know. I thank God for those cornerstones and those statutes that we came up under, because it did become an anchor. And I was talking with a good friend that I just met, and he was telling me how ships always have an anchor, but they're not meant to stay down. They're always attached to the ship, and when you go off to foreign places, whenever it gets too far out there, that anchor's still there, and you know where to drop it.
Wow.
And so that's what I have. No, undeniably and unequivocally, people cannot deny the word and the anointing.
But you knew you were pushing the envelope a long time ago. You knew that.
Well, I don't want to say that. Like people would say, well, you wore, you know, the boa, the top hat, and all the stuff, you know, when you first came out, and, you know, you can't do that. I said, well, I didn't know what to be afraid of, because I was just doing what I always did. I wasn't just doing that because I was going there, and I certainly didn't know the gatekeepers were against it. I didn't know who the gatekeepers were.
Right.
I was just doing me. You know, I'm an artist. I'm a recording artist. I'm not a gospel artist. I'm not a Christian artist. I'm not a secular artist. I'm an artist.
And that's another question.
Yeah.
Aren't you singing gospel music? Aren't you?
I do sing gospel music. I do share the good news of the cross, death, burial, resurrection. But I also speak of life. I'm a life artist as well. Stuff can be very autobiographical in the sense that I tell the truth, sometimes even to my own hurt.
Hmm.
So some may look at that as self-inflicting or even career shattering, but I call it freeing myself.
Wow.
So that I'm not living the facade that I see a lot of other people have to live for economic reasons or for ministerial reasons, or they won't appear in this particular conference and they'll no longer be accepted by this particular group of people and cross pollinate each other's
don't
stuff.
Go there. Don't did you
yeah,
go there?
I went there.
Let's go here. You were angry at one point, and I think that was in your freeing
several
points, moments.
The big one was
the big one was when the whole big thing over the internet is Tone made this song and Tone's cussing.
Right.
You were mad.
Yeah.
You were mad. Okay. You were past mad. You were pissed.
Yes.
What were you pissed about?
Because I was tired of the hypocrisy. And we all have been hypocrites at some point in this walk for reasons of concession or compromise or for career or for just trying to make other people happy.
Hmm.
And when I decided to be real and truthful, because the truth sets me free, so they told me, so the word says, why is this truth now deemed demonic when I was practically living a lie by compressing it and pretending everything was okay?
What were you living a lie? What was a lie?
I wasn't able to say just how angry I was about the unfair treatment and practices that I'd experienced from not just one denomination, but just, and not even blanketing this over the entire body of Christ, but when someone's already down, and someone's already lost everything that's important to them.
Hmm.
You know, particularly that, well, from 04 to 07, when that song was released, I had lost.